to DB Overland and welcome to part two of the Roamer series of the camper conversion. In this video, I'm going to be putting the back hatch on this trailer, and also I get to tell you guys what my surprise is. Well, time sure has gone by since the last time I actually did any work on the trailer. I know, I've been slacking. I've been failing you guys. I'm sorry. Anyways, let me get you caught up on the trailer. A little bit has happened since then. I actually had to use the trailer for one of my events, my meet and greet. You'll have to check that out. And so I needed my trailer, and so I kind of did a few things just to get it to where it could go down the road. It's not how I want it, but it worked for the time being. But I plan on continuing forward with the idea that I have up here to give you this awesome creation and to inspire you guys to build your own trailer. So, like I said, we are going to build the back hatch for this area. I'm gonna show you guys this awesome drawer slide. Sure does come in handy. So, what have I done since the last time you guys have seen it? I added some taillights, because I had to have those to go down the highway. Okay. And that's what I've got. Simple creation. It worked well. For the time being, I just temporarily put bars up here so I can mount my tent to it. Temporary. Not exactly what I want. So that will be, these will be coming off and I will be building exactly what I want. And then the suspension on the trailer was actually too soft. The factory rear Jeep Cherokee springs just could not start holding the weight. Now, if I were to change a few things around, sure, but the way that it's set up, the axle actually would have bottomed out to the frame. So I ended up going into my parts department and I made my own leaf springs to accommodate for the additional weight. Now, I have thought about, but I didn't need to, just ordering a set of rear lifted leaf springs for a Cherokee. And depending on what size tire you want to run, you can go with any size lift. But since I had the parts laying around, I just decided to go ahead and use what I've got. But I'll show you what I did. It turned out pretty good. So there is the custom spring pack that I built. And I went ahead and installed the shocks that I had laying around to help control this guy from bouncing like a maniac. So, there you go. That is everything that has happened to the trailer since the last time you guys saw it. So, I got my materials cut, ready to go. Let's make ourselves a back hatch, and I will tell you guys more in detail about this slide out. Okay, let me show you guys what we're going to be using for materials today for the back hatch. So, what we've got here, this is 3/4 by 3/4 by 065 square tubing, and I already cut it out of 45. So this is going to be the framework for my door. And then I have my hinge plate here, which is a piece of 1.5 by 3/16. This is what I'm gonna mount my hinges to on the body of the camper. And then I've got this nice latch here for the back, lockable. They work great. Came with a rubber gasket. Oh, that's a satisfying sound. Like I said, lockable. And then for hinges, I am using half barrel hinges. Now these are great because you can grease them. They come apart very easily. And all you do is you weld one side to your door and then the other side to your hinge mount. And depending on how you can weld these, you can make it to where your door is removable or it is not. These are a really nice hinge to use. They're great in the manufacturing industry for outdoor gates and horse trailers and all sorts of stuff. So this is what I am using for the hatch. Now, I believe each one of these is rated for 250 pounds each. And you can clearly see how small they are. So I think they're gonna work super awesome because there is no way that the hatch is gonna weigh that much. So, and then also, I have the skin of the door, which I cut it out of 18 gauge steel plate. And there you go. There is the back hatch. And that is gonna actually, let's see here. Lock that in place. Set that up in there like that. And so there you go. It's gonna be something like that. So, now that we've got all of our pieces, let's start welding up a rear hatch for the camper. Out pretty good, I think. I got it all nice and buffed off in my corners. And I did a stitch welding. You do not need to do 100% welding. I mean, you got a short weld, short weld, short weld. See, that's stitch welding. And that keeps the material from distorting and warping on you. Now, even just in this stitch welding, this panel was wanting to come this way, so that's why I put in this center brace to also stiffen up the door, but to help keep that panel from bowing. So, yeah, this is great. So now I need to see about getting it fitted in there. So let's take a gander real quick. I have not test fitted this yet, so your eyes are going to be the same as my eyes. Let's see if I can't move this around a little bit. Not too bad for weight wise. It's got a little bit of weight on it, but oh, come on. Houston, I think we have a problem. So, there. What I mean by problem is, you can see down here how I've got a nice gap, and then as we go up, it actually isn't going in. And then over here, got a nice gap. And then down there, it's touching. So what that tells me, that the whole bed rails, or the boxes, sorry, not the bed rails, the boxes are like this. So I'm gonna see if I can't put a jack or like a high lift jack or something and see if I can't pull those boxes that way a little bit and help square everything up. We'll see. The way that I welded it like a unibody construction on a car. So everything is tied into each other. So hopefully I can get it to rack over and square up a little bit better. Because if not, that's gonna be a big royal pain in the butt. But I think I can do it. And then the question is, after I do it, is it gonna stay? Because I don't need it going back. Because that would suck. So I'm gonna see if I can't do that. And then from there, we're gonna mount our hinge plate. This guy. And it's gonna go just like a SOA. And the reason why I'm putting this on here is because this is light gauge steel. And I don't want the stress to be put on here. I'd rather the weight of the door be put on this, and then I could weld this, I could stitch weld this, and then the whole, it distributes the load and the weight of the door equally amongst this panel instead of just two little tiny parts or points of contact, I should say. So that'll be next. And then after that, we can work on the I guess you would say the door frame on the inside. So then that way when the door shuts, it's got a nice surface that it can seal up against to try to help keep out the dust and all of the rain and stuff like that. Because I'd like to try to have some of these storage compartments and the center section airtight or almost airtight for dust and stuff like that. So let's see what we can do to try to straighten this thing back out. Cross our fingers, right? Pick up progress. So this is what I was talking about on doing a door frame. So you can see I've added in this piece of angle iron on this side and back in there on that side. And so that's going to allow a nice tight seal on this door when I go to close it. Boom. And hopefully that'll keep some of the weather out. So I end up using a 1 inch by 1 inch by 1/8 inch thick angle iron, but it's not gonna work on the bottom. So I'm thinking what I might end up doing is seeing about running like a piece of 3/4 inch tall angle iron, because my 1 inch just barely touches the top of this slide out. So if I go with a piece of 3/4, it should give me enough clearance for this to slide out. And then also I can seal up against the bottom right here. Because like I said, eventually it's gonna be sealed up completely. I know I've got to go back and do a lot of sealing up, but I think that'll allow the door to close tight and keep a lot of the dust out. And not so much the rain, just mainly dust. Dust is the big enemy. So yeah. So I'm gonna get myself a piece of 3/4 inch angle iron and run a piece across the bottom and then weld it up. And then after that, we can install the latch. Where is my latch? Okay. Stay. Okay, so. There it is. Okay, so next we've got this guy. Beautiful thing. And I'm thinking about mounting it right here in the center. Oh yeah, look at that. I think that'll work out just perfect. And then that way, this piece right here will hook on that angle iron and allow for a nice click tight lock. I think that'll be perfect. So I'll get the door frame buttoned up and then we'll cut in for the latch, and that'll be great. Are you ready? I give you a completed hatch. Get my light going on here. Okay, so we have the door frame fully finished. Perfect. We've got the rear hatch. Perfect. Now, I did have to clearance this latch a little bit because the fitment, I'll show you, the fitment was very, very tight. So I had to grind a little bit so then that way it would actually latch. But look at that. Slight push and it clicks right in. Absolutely perfect. I think that turned out really, really, really well for the situation with that door frame not quite being perfectly squared from the boxes moving like we found out earlier. But hey, I got a door to fit. It will seal up when I get the weather stripping in there. And I think it's going to be perfect. Oh, that feels really, really good. Smooth. I mean, that's really good hinge alignment. That's pretty good. And I can just grease it over time, you know, and that will help with water. Now, when you use these half barrel hinges, I always like to put the grease zerks at the top because this body of the hinge is hollow to accept the pin that is pressed into this lower section. So when it rains, your water is going to run down this way, where if you had the grease zerk at the bottom, if the water was coming this way, it has a chance to get inside and fill up this cavity right here, this pocket for the pin. So I always put grease zerks at the top, and that prevents water from coming in, and it works slick. All right. So another thing about these hinges is, you can see my top hinge here. I have grease zerk side welded to the door, and I have pin side welded to the body. And I have the lower one the exact same way. And what this does is it allows me to remove this door to do some servicing. Now, if I was to take one of these hinges and reverse welding it, so instead of the grease zerk to the door, I would go grease zerk to the body and pin to the door, that would actually prevent the door from being able to come off. So you can get creative and make it to where you can have a removable door. Or if you don't want a removable door, then you can switch the pattern of welding it. So I wanted it to be a removable door, but some people say, oh, well, people can get into it. Well, you can't, because the door is recessed into the door frame. You cannot just lift up and gain access to this. It would be probably impossible. So that turned out really, really good. I am extremely happy with that. So the next big question is the drawer slide, is it going to fit with this lower piece added in? Now, according to my measurements, I was good, just barely. I mean, just barely, but I was going to be good. So I'm going to grab this drawer and get it in here, and let's see how it's going to fit. Thank you. Are we gonna clear? Are we gonna clear? Oh. Oh. Look at that. Just barely. Can't get much closer than that. Look at that. I thought it was just barely. Wow. So there we go. A perfect fit. I couldn't ask for anything better. That that was awesome. And I really thought that I was screwed there for a bit when I found out that that door frame was not perfectly square. So a win. I'll take it. I will take it. So there we go. There is the buttoning up of the camper conversion. Yeah, I would say camper conversion done. Done, done, done. And that's just turning out awesome. Very awesome. Now, I really haven't done anything up here. It's kind of hard to see. I did put a little bogey wheel on it just to make it easier. But there you go. Camper conversion done. So, what's next for the roamer? That's a good question. You know, I think what I am going to do next is, right now, this trailer, it feels too utilitarian. I need to make it more off-road aggressive looking, if you kind of know what I mean. So, I think the next thing that we are going to do for this little trailer is we're going to give it some body armor. I'm going to give it some body armor. I'm going to do rock sliders, tubed fender flare, more rock slider wrapped around into the front tongue here with a complete storage system up front for my fridge. Will be right here. I may go wider with the axle even, because on my trip that I used the camper, it followed beautifully. It towed like it wasn't even behind the truck. And when I took it off road, it would cut corners super well. But I did notice that with the tent on top and with the gear being fully loaded, I wouldn't say it was top heavy, but it was concerning me just a little bit. So I may actually go yet again wider with the axle, but I want to change my axle out. Originally, I was planning on towing this behind my Jeep Cherokee. Now that I'm towing it with a new vehicle, which you guys will hear shortly see, it is much wider than my newer vehicle. So, and also, it has the wrong bolt pattern to my new vehicle. So, I want to match the bolt pattern with the trailer and the new vehicle that I'm towing this with, because I want to say probably 90% of the time this trailer is getting towed is going to be with two vehicles that have the same bolt pattern And so I want this to have the same bolt pattern as those two vehicles. So I'm going to be, again, revamping that axle. And so I think that will be the next thing. We'll do the axle, full body armor, going into front storage compartment. And also, I want to take care of the jack up front. So the jack up front, where'd it go? Oh, hold on, let me get my light for you guys real quick here. Okay, so my jack situation right now is it's fixed and I don't like it because when that bogey wheel is all the way up, I've hit it a few times. So I'm gonna make a removable jack for the front, and then in the rear, I want to make legs that I can insert into a pocket or something that can come down and stabilize the back of this because of how well balanced this trailer is. It does not take much weight. That's why actually I had this ladder here. Does not take much weight for it to tip back. So when I have the tent set up on this trailer, I'm always afraid that it's gonna fall back, especially when you gotta pull out that drawer slide. So I'm gonna get some stabilizer legs for the back here that will be part of the body armor protection system. So I think that is quite a to-do list. So thank you everyone for following me along on this build. I am extremely excited about it. I'm extremely excited to show you guys, and I've been seeing on the channel that it is one of the series that you guys really, really like. So please hit that subscribe button, give it a thumbs up, click that notification bell, because 95% of you people that are watching my videos are unsubscribed. So hey, it doesn't cost you anything and it helps motivate me to build cool stuff like this, because I've got a few other trailers that I'd like to do with you guys. So hit that subscribe button. Until next video, we'll see you out on the trail.